It starts at 8 and is over at 10. If you're looking to get a deal, you might want to check out the tailgate garage sale as well. We have the town of Minto bringing greetings. Thank you to the counselors who were able to come. Oh, and they have a few candies left, so make sure you get out there and grab those. I'm sure you will see their faces around tonight and then all weekend as well. Randy Pettypiece, our MPP, is here. Our member of provincial parliament. I'm sure he's been very busy. I think there's a lot going on right now in Toronto, and I'd probably love to talk to all of us about that. I'm sure we are all aware that we have the opportunity to vote this fall, and so running for Minto Council is Glenn Hall, and he wants to remind everyone to get out and vote in October. He would like your support, but I'm sure more than anything he'd like each and every one of us to make sure we vote, because voting is important. And I'm sure if you have any questions, he could answer anything you would like to know. Princesses or ambassadors could not be any cuter. Look at that smile and that wave. I hope that when she kind of turns this corner, everyone gives a big wave and a big smile. Look at those three. And in a few short years, they will be representing, I'm sure, the Agriculture Society as well. Also happening tomorrow is the Birds of Prey show here at the arena, starting at 10. Bounty Councils, of course, and the Children's Village is free and open all day, starting at 10 till 4 tomorrow. The pet show, if you have a pet that you would like to bring, be sure to put it in the pet show tomorrow, starting at 10. Thank you to Courtney Miller. If you're ever looking for a DJ, Repeat Entertainment is definitely someone you can call. He's local and he is able to not only blast the tunes, but it looks like put on a bit of a smoke show as well. One, that tomorrow is the last day for the Palmerston Farmers Market, so to be sure to get any of the vegetables or baked goods that you want. They do a great job, and we thank them for having a farmers market every week for us in the summer. And if you're not feeling like cooking dinner tomorrow night, you can join them at the corn roast. And if you're really hungry, you might want to venture in to be part of the corn eating contest. We have North Wellington Co-op with their fleet of vehicles here. Their classic Ford, which I'm sure has seen many miles but is still looking very good, is reminding us that we've had our co-op in our community since 1944, and that we really need to remember that they are there for our fuel needs, as well as if you happen to be a farmer and are looking for someone to spray your fields, that they can get that done for you as well. And it looks like with that machine it's not going to take very long because that's rather large. Interested in dance or know someone interested in dance, we have a new dance company here in Palmerston. It's the IMDA Dance Academy. And I encourage you to check out their website for more information as well as potentially signing up. We have friend Ty Miller in his McCormick Farm Hall, and he's pulling an international 100, and that's a manure spreader. For those of you who maybe aren't from the farm, of course today's ours will look much bigger and get done much faster. Following him is Lauren Heimiller in a John Deere. It's from the early 50s. He's pulling behind him many different antiques, including at least 5 antique plows, and those belong to his son. Behind them we have Wally. You might know him as Gator. He's in a 1950 D case, and it's 30 horsepower. Paul Bowl just finished restoring his John Deere 620 this spring. It's a 1958, and he told me earlier tonight that it has always been and belongs somewhere in the town of Minto. Talk about small town big dreams. Henry and Mark Stevens are on Sunday going to go live their small town big dreams. They hope to take their spider to every province and territory in Canada at some point, and they're headed out east to get that journey started on Sunday. Well done to those 4 ladies who decorated their bikes and their helmets. They look great. The Cole and McLaughlin girls, I think. Larry Dickinson would like to remind everyone to bring your antique tractors to the tractor show tomorrow to show off your pride and joy. This is his pride and joy. He has 2 Fords, a 4000 and a 7000 series. Oh, I think our little bike rider is getting mighty tired, but thanks to the bunny for giving a push. It's a long bike ride on those little legs. Thank you goes to the Shriners. They do so much good for children in our community, and we always appreciate everything we do, and when we can, we support you back as well. Thank you. Stuart Sales and Service from Listowel, Elmira, and Mildmay wants to wish the Agriculture Society and the community a good harvest and successful fair. I mentioned that we have a new dance academy here in Palmerston starting, but we are lucky enough in the town of Minto to have 2 dance academies. We have the Minto Dance Academy that is placed out of Harrison for ages 3 and up. I know that you can sign up tonight at mass registration, so whether you're interested in jazz, contemporary, musical theater, hip hop, and many more, consider signing up and joining them. You have the opportunity, if you'd like. Again, we're voting this October, just a reminder, we're all voting this October. And Terry Fisk would like your vote for mayor of the town of Minto. And I'm sure, again, he will be around off and on all weekend and would love to answer any questions or hear your thoughts and ideas for what you would like to see in the town of Minto. Thank you, Jason Snyder and Sons. North Perth Towing. We all hope never to have to use your services, but in unexpected emergencies, we are very happy that you are around. We have Brody Schiestel driving his crazy trains. So he takes these to Barney every Saturday to race them, and if you notice, those